Hold on, I think we're live. Maybe that we're live.
Oh, I see you liked my post. I still don't see a like button myself, though.
And we're live, I think. This is Brandon from OUYA Central TV, and I got Killswitch from the OUYA forums and Eldon McGinnis from the forums also. He's a developer on OUYA, and we're going to talk about this AMA with the CEO of Razer and see what's going to happen with this this buyout. The developer on OUYA and
all kinds of good stuff.
So stay tuned. We're going to try to show what's going on here on their forum. If you guys want to get the link is in the description if you're watching this live. Maybe, maybe not, or maybe later. That's why we did this, or that's why we're doing this. So for anyone that's not able to catch this live, can check it out later. And I think we should be starting soon. They sent out a tweet. Razer sent out a tweet. And we'll see how this goes. So how do you guys feel about this whole situation? I guess we just didn't have no questions answered right now on like how everything's going to merge over or when it's going to merge over. I know Killswitch and I are coming from the perspective of a gamer and what games we purchased on the OUYA, and Eldon's on the perspective of a developer and seeing how his apps can be put on the Forge TV by Razer.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I'm actually curious on the customer side too, because you know I love a lot of the games that are on there, and
right.
if I were, you know, to get a Forge down the road, or you know whatever happens with the OUYA store, I'm very interested to find out, because you know DRM is just one of those things we kind of have to live with in the model that we're using. So,
all right, it says that they have Mr. Tin with them right now, and they said let's get the AMA started.
Where are you seeing that?
That is on the update at 8:00.
Okay.
So everybody right now is most popular like comment is what discount will be offered for the Forge TV bundle and standalone? Because currently the bundle is at $150 and the standalone by itself without the controller is $100.
Oh, and it looks like actually they announced they've answered that question. We'll be announcing that when the integration of the OUYA platform is ready for Forge TV, which will be sometime Q4 of this year.
Okay. Where are you getting that information?
A little further down. I'm on the first page, I'm on the third page actually. And somebody posted there a staff member. Oh, it's actually the Tan guy. I'm going to butcher this name
Mr.
probably.
Tan.
Yes, Mr. Tan. We'll go with that. He said that actually right there in reply to his question. It looks like he's just going through replying to questions.
Okay.
What'll happen to existing console credit? Says he'll be keeping the lights on for existing boxes, which should also apply to your console credit. Doesn't give a time frame for how long he'll be keeping them on, but... And it says, when we migrate to the new Cortex TV, we'll do what we can to see if we can migrate the console credits too, but that's something we need to evaluate technically to see if it's feasible, so no promises. Which then I kind of have to ask the question, what do you mean by migrate to the new Cortex TV? Are you migrating the OUYAs to Cortex TV?
All the OUYA content will be migrated to Cortex. Don't know if that means the boxes will.
Because they didn't purchase the hardware.
Mm-hmm.
Well, who would purchase hardware that's
old?
It's old. Yeah.
It was old when it came out.
Yeah, true that.
So it looks like it's just going to be one of those things. If you have an auto refresh script on your browser, just click that, set it for a couple of minutes.
So he's just going to be, so this is going to last like an hour.
That's going to be painful. Let's see.
Yeah, we need to rapid fire some more questions here.
I'm scrolling through. He only answered those two. He must be answering the other ones now. All right, here we go. Can the apps and games be stored, accessed, and run from external storage? For the Forge TV, sideloading of apps will be subject to the way Android TV is architected by Google as we're running Android TV on it.
So that would be a yes, because Android will let you unless Forge locks you down.
Right.
So,
but I mean, pretty much you can sideload. I guess you have to have like a file manager in order to access the APK files.
I wonder if the question is more towards that external storage part.
Right.
Because
right.
That's the one that's not there.
Right. Like on the OUYA, where you can put a thumb drive in and use the extra storage. That's what.
Yeah.
So I
but
guess
since they got the tech from OUYA, they should be able to take care of that quick.
Right. They should be able to help them out with that.
The Forge TV is out already, isn't it?
Yes.
So is that not a feature it has as of now?
Right.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. He's answering another question.
Okay. All right. This is not how I expected it to go, but at least you're getting him actually answering questions.
All right. So I guess you got to find out which ones he's answering. It should populate to the top of the list. That way
you could stay on one page and kind of see what's going on.
Yeah, so they're showing that the first question was answered, but it wasn't answered with, right next to it. You have to go further down in the thread.
Yeah. Well, all right.
He must be answering the kill switch question right now.
It says, will Cortex be available to other Android devices? And he's saying, we hope so. We'll do what we can to enable Cortex TV Game Store to be available on other Android TV devices, but that's subject to how third-party companies allow us to do so. We believe in openness, and we hope everyone else does too.
Okay. Yeah, I remember hearing that word openness.
Yeah, before. That's. I'm surprised he even brought that one with him to the show.
Cortex everywhere.
I mean, it would be great, you know? I mean, that's what I was kind of digging, was that whole idea of OUYA everywhere, but, you know, it didn't work out.
I mean, they can use it like the Amazon App Store, pretty much.
Yeah.
It'd be like the Cortex TV store, game store.
Yeah, the problem for OUYA is it just came way too early in the life cycle. Because there weren't enough games that want, you know, games that would get people to actually pick up the system.
Right.
And then when there were games, they were never showcased.
Yeah, that's when I think they started that, OUYA Presents. And they started doing that with mostly fairly newer games. They went back a little bit for some older games, but.
Yeah, but if you think about it, things like on OUYA Forum, I've been running the Meltdown Nights. Look how it gets the whole forum paying attention. Even if they weren't playing, at least they were paying attention to it. And it was one of the better games on the console.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it still is.
Yeah. All right, we got another question. When do you plan to cease support for the current OUYA hardware? And what exactly will that mean? And then he said, we didn't acquire the OUYA hardware business, and we don't provide any support for it. However, out of goodwill, we're keeping the lights on for the next 12 months or so for the software service associated with it. That much said, from what I know of the device as a hardware device, The OUYA hardware box should still work standalone without the servers to run the apps already on it.
You know, Kill Switch, I know you're the 12 months thing. You're tired of hearing it, but he keeps saying 12 months. That's not helping it.
Yeah.
12 months or so. So
that's looking more and more like a hard 12 months to me.
Well, everything's going to, what I'm thinking he's going by is everything will be merged over to Cortex, and hopefully most of the OUYA people will be picking up a Forge. That's what I'm guessing.
Mm.
Because if you think about it, people have been waiting for an OUYA 2, and this is basically it.
All right. Is the plan to get all/some of OUYA games published to Google Play? We'll do what we can to support the developers to do it, but at the end of the day, it's the choice of the developers, and OUYA will work towards enabling it. But yes, that's the vision.
What would he have to do with Google Play? I don't understand. They're making their own store. Using OUYA's store, so I'm not sure what that had to do with anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's some of these questions.
Oh, they look like they're all coming from the same person, Jack Frost 81.
Yeah, that's Victor.
That's Victor. He's bringing questions from the forum.
Oh, okay.
So you'll see some questions that have been answered like 20 times. Now, that was just really aggravating to me because they already answered. Let's get the questions that people actually want to hear.
All right. I don't see anything.
Netflix has to be answered. He can't avoid that one.
Yeah. Yeah, the streaming services, I mean, no matter what anyone says, are a big thing with any console now.
Right.
If you're not doing streaming services, I mean, that's going to be a huge hit.
Well, they have streaming, just not Netflix, Amazon, and whatever the other one was.
Yeah, I mean, Tubby TV doesn't really count. I mean, they had Fraggle Rock.
Hulu's there, or it was.
I never cared for Hulu. They always did commercials, even when you were a paid customer. That annoyed me.
Okay, when will Cortex with OUYA games be available on the Forge TV?
Same question.
I think so. This is a minute ago. Yeah. I don't know.
That's the same type of question, but I think it's just he answered it again.
We estimate sometime in quarter 4, 2015. So that's...
Around the same time they announced
October, November, December.
Yeah. Same time they plan on announcing the discount that'll be available.
Okay.
Oh, I finally get the like button. Now I'm seeing it.
All right.
It's completely random. I don't know why that was gone.
Okay, no. It's like you gotta jump around every little page. Go on. How about Kill Switch's question?
Reload every 5 seconds.
Okay. So it looks like they're going through the questions on the front.
He's moved to back to the front page?
Well, on the front page, it shows the ones that were answered already. Yes, they answered on the question.
This must be another feature I'm not seeing. Oh, okay, I see it now. I'm just blind.
Will existing OUYA owners be able to use their current controller if they choose to merge to the Forge device for their hardware platform? He did not answer that question. Is there like a dislike button?
Just reply back to him. Stop it.
It's a Bluetooth controller. That's common sense.
They do have a report button. You could report him for being a moron.
People asked about side loading and the controller. The two things we answer every day.
Let's see. Man, it's taking them forever to answer these questions.
I wonder if he hit Eldon's spot. Because there you have, what, 7 or 8 questions?
Yeah, I think it was like 8 or 9.
When will Netflix be released for The Forge? You did not answer that one. Is The Forge 2 coming out?
Really?
I'm just joking. Saying the truth, I have a Forge and I haven't even opened it yet. All right, we got a question from Lightly KD. All right, I'll do the first one and then you do the second one, and then I'll do the third one. Okay. He's got a couple. Okay, here. What happens to your DM lock purchases from OUYA's Discover Store? Some OUYA games can be played with and recognize your purchase whist offline. Many don't. In 12 months, will users lose access to all of their games if they decide not to merge to The Forge? And he says, we did not acquire the hardware business of OUYA, and we're keeping the lights on for the next couple of months. Two months of goodwill to the users. I'm not aware of the specifics of each game and probably cannot comment on that, but to the best extent of our ability, we will try to get as many games/accounts merged across to the Forge TV.
Couple. Man.
Wow. It went from 12 to couple.
I know, right? I take it back. I'll go with 12. Come on.
All right. He said, next question. What will be the transfer process in regards to games? Will users be able to plug in their OUYA hard drive into the Forge and have their games be recognized, or will we have to delete all of our games and reinstall them on the Forge, essentially forcing us to start all of our games from scratch? We're still working this out in the back end and should have more information when we're ready to launch the new Cortex TV store on Forge. Okay. Any chance Razer might nix the Forge name and simply call the current Forge, or maybe the name of the next box, OUYA 2, with the OUYA console had its ups and downs, the name is still very popular among gamers. Nope. OUYA will be publishing ARM moving forward, and Forge will be the name of the console.
So OUYA is going to be their software catalog, it sounds. Well, no, it can't be, because if they're calling it Cortex, was it Cortex or just Cortex TV? I think it was just Cortex.
Cortex TV store. But OUYA, I guess, will be the publisher.
Huh.
OUYA Publishing most likely takes care of, you know, the OUYA part.
Right.
Gotcha.
Like they are, like they do with the Mi Box.
Gotcha.
The Xiaomi. If you look at the games on there, the publishers are OUYA, because I guess OUYA is, I guess, publishing it on that device.
Huh.
All right.
Yeah, that DRM is going to be an interesting issue when that starts to kick in.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see.
I don't think it's going to be that much of an issue. I mean, there aren't... I mean... It depends on the games, but, you know, some of the developers won't bring their games over, but the ones who are responsible will, you know, look into that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, you would hope so.
Okay, well, here's another question. What will the difference be? What will be the difference between the Cortex for Android TV store and OUYA as a brand name as a publisher on the Google Play Store? He said Cortex TV will be a store on the Forge TV. OUYA will be a publisher of games to stores like Cortex TV, Google Play, Xiaomi, Alibaba, etc.
That just seems like a hot mess.
So you can actually purchase a game that OUYA published on the Cortex TV store the Google Play Store, the Xiaomi, Alibaba, and etc.
I'm not sure how that's going to work out.
I mean, developers do that now. They have, okay, the game on, say, Android on the Google Play Store. They have it on the Amazon App Store.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be on the Cortex TV App Store.
Well, I was just referring to the OUYA will be a publisher of games to stores. Like, so is OUYA going to be kind of like a man in the middle helping you publish your game to all of these stores? I mean, that's what I was reading out of that.
Right.
The second part, at least.
Yeah, basically, it's just it's OUYA everywhere, but they're a publisher instead of a company. Well, not company, you know. Not OUYA.
They're just a branch.
Right, right. Yeah, kind of like Westinghouse or whatever.
Like Crescent Moon or whoever else is out there.
I was just looking at kind of like the logistics of it, though. You know, controller differences, system differences, you know. I mean.
Right. You have to.
How is that? Is that going to be, you know, they're going to hand you with a integration packet, so to say, you know, look out for all of these when you're publishing to XYZ? Or is it just kind of like lip service? This is our publisher. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but some of these questions are really questions that can wait until later. Should really be getting to what's happening right now.
Yeah.
That's part of where the problem's going to be. Because after this is done, he's going to have to actually get another AMA or something out there for more of these questions.
And it looks like he answered somebody asked what will happen with the current OUYA hardware. We acquired a portion of the assets of OUYA, basically only the store platform and the publishing business. I'm not aware of their plans for hardware.
Can we leave the hardware alone? Well, one thing about him is at least he's answering the questions.
Mm-hmm. Did
Wow. That's interesting. You see that last one he's got here? Actually, very interesting language from a CEO. Will I be able to get OUYA games on my Shield TV somehow, i.e. Cortex or OUYA games published to Google Play? Yes, we made the decision not to be a bunch of... should I say it?
No. Yeah.
Okay. And keep the content for ourselves. We believe in openness. Like the work we do on OS, VR, etc. I have no idea what that is. And we wanted to get the games to be on as many platforms as possible. Very interesting for us, CEO, though, nonetheless.
Well, the OS VR is their, have a VR headset.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Oh, virtual reality.
And they just signed a big deal for it, too.
Yeah, I saw something that.
China. Interesting. Yeah, did not expect him to say that.
No, it didn't either. I had to read it twice. I'm like, what? Wait, what?
Yeah, they announced today at China Joy, Chinese software giant 360 is setting up a VR app store for their OS VR.
Oh, boy. I don't know. I never cared for virtual reality, but maybe somebody will do it right.
I feel the same way.
I actually tried it out with the Google Cardboard, where and you can use your phone. It's pretty neat.
I think the last thing that I even seen that had anything to do with VR, I was watching a special about people trying to use virtual reality to help themselves get over different phobias and stuff. It's actually pretty interesting, but, I mean, game-wise, I don't know, man.
All right, next question. Any plans to update OUYA.TV? And his answer is, I'm not sure. No, I'm not sure I understand this question, actually. If it's the website, yep. We'll get the updates at some point. We'll get that updated at some point.
I could only assume they meant the site. I mean,
yeah.
Yeah.
The website.
Again, site was never that popular anyways. I thought it was horrible. So, I mean, anything will be an improvement.
I almost never go to the site.
I only went to the site just to see what new games came out.
Yeah. But then I gave up on that, yeah.
But then you didn't have to... Then Elden created the OUYA wiki and...
Yeah.
You didn't need them to go there anymore.
Yeah.
I have to because I have to post them to the forum. But besides that, I don't touch it. This is kind of odd how this is all set up.
Yeah. He's just going through answering questions.
So far, nothing directly addressing that DRM, unfortunately. Because I know a lot of people are questioning that.
Mm-hmm.
That's something he can't answer because that's the developers.
Oh, yeah. No, I'd imagine the answer is going to be, you know, as long as we keep the OUYA lights on, you know, your stuff's going to validate. After that, you know, you're on your own. Which, I mean, it's not that bad in the grand scheme of things as long as your OUYA never screws up and you have to reset it, because unless you're able to get that initial validation, none of the premium games really work. Well, I won't say none of them. There's probably a few of them that were premium and didn't actually do DRM. But for any of the other ones, even the ones that cached receipts, you know, if you happen to have the APK, it still wouldn't work.
Okay, I guess we missed a question. Will the devs be paid for what they're currently owed? He just said yes.
I think, didn't he already cover that? I mean, he's even going out of his way to cover that those free the games people, which I thought was stand up of him.
Mm-hmm.
Even though they're still complaining about now how that they have to give out keys and stuff or give out licenses in exchange for the money. I mean, I only think that's reasonable, but
yeah, I'm not going to say it.
I mean, me personally, I would have bounded even further. I would have said, you know, unless somebody actually downloads your game too, don't expect to get the money, you know. Because if you want $10,000, you give 10,000 keys, 10,000 people don't download it, you know what I mean? That doesn't make any sense.
Well, to me, it's more about the ones who burned the money and the other ones who didn't even care about the console in the first place.
Right.
Now they're crying for the money when, you know, if it wasn't for that... the free to games, they wouldn't be getting all that extra money, and they're not even putting out the games.
Yeah,
I'm not going to name names, but at least two are on Steam.
You know who they? You know who you are. You probably don't listen to this, but anyways, talking about the DRM. Didn't PR Solar like get rid of their DRM?
I don't know. I haven't tried it.
I never checked.
I can definitely give it a try. I can definitely give it a try. It'd be interesting to see if it works on Cyanogen too.
Well, I thought there was one game that they did fix that DRM issue.
They said they were going to. Yeah, they said they were going to, and I know Killswitch had told me that they said they were going to.
I think they did update it, if I remember correctly.
It looks like we had a couple of new posts here. As a developer, what do I need to launch a game on Cortex? It says get in touch with the OUYA publishing team.
Why don't people listen?
So Cortex is going to be run by OUYA.
That's what it's sounding like.
Mm-hmm.
It's not even that. It's I keep telling people the same thing. OUYA has not stopped taking submissions. Get your games in. Use the ODK.
Right. And the ODK will give them OUYA everywhere, right?
Yeah.
You know, I have to wonder though, are they going to keep using the ODK? Like, is Forge going to use the ODK? Because if it is going to use the ODK, then again, they don't even need a proxy to handle the DRM and stuff. They just literally need to redirect the URL to their own server.
Right.
And they could keep the lights on indefinitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you know.
I mean, assuming they use the same SDK, the OUYA ODK, you know, I mean.
The ODK is going to be the same for now. I mean, I can't guarantee it won't change, obviously, but right now, it's the same process.
Right.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, even if they do change it, though, if they're still using the ODK, even in the beginning with Forge, you know what I mean? Even if they do publish games with the ODK and bring them over to Forge TV, I would think just for legacy, the legacy factor of it, they'd have to continue support for that interface, that protocol, you know what I mean? They couldn't just abandon it with the next update because then they'd be losing part of their catalog for people who don't update.
Well, they can always make some type of merged system, which, I mean, OUYA and Cortex are basically going to be merged.
Yeah, it goes back to what we were saying earlier, you know, like a proxy to handle both type of call type situation.
Right.
Yeah, which, those are questions that really shouldn't be asked right now, because there are other things like, you know, the discount, will things work, how are things going to go forward? Because some of these can wait until, you know, until things get moving.
I don't know, as a dev, man, those are important questions for me. I need to know, should I move on a little bit? Should I even consider keeping on down this road? This stability does help a little bit. It does help to know things a little bit, even just a general direction. Are you aiming to do this, or am I just pipe dreaming right now?
Well, I mean, that's pretty much what they've been saying, though. And they are taking submissions. Well, they aren't really saying much, but they are taking submissions. So that should be, you know, that should be a sign for at least the developers that you can still keep doing what you're doing for now.
Yeah, the most recent game that just got published is that, Cheeky Chickens?
Cheeky Chickens. That's hilarious.
Yeah, Angry Birds.
Okay, we got another question. It says, does my current purchases transfer over only to Cortex through Google Play under the OUYA publisher or both? We're working on trying to get the accounts merged to the best of our ability, but not all content may be transferred, though we'll do whatever we can to do so. The transfers will be to the Cortex account.
So that's a no to being both Google Play and Cortex, but yes, they are trying to transfer it to Cortex. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's kind of to be expected.
Okay, we're at, well, looks like we're halfway through. Answered, what, about 10 questions so far?
Yeah.
And I keep seeing Google Play everywhere.
Okay, here's another one. I don't think we've got this one. Do you plan to update OUYA to include Forge TV features? And the answer is no. We don't have any insight of the hardware or underlying software, and probably won't be able to do so without significant reverse engineering work.
Interesting.
So that answers the question.
Yeah. So, I mean... Is there an update coming?
As a developer, what do I... Oh, no, I got that one.
Yeah. Let's see. Anything new yet? Working that mouse.
I'm trying to see if there's a way. Is there a way to like...
Wait, is there like an RSS feed for this forum? There might be.
I'm trying to click on his profile, maybe try to pick up.
No. Oh well.
I'm on his profile. There's just people posting on his recent activity. Here we go. Okay. This looks a little bit better. It should show up on the feed. Probably not as big as it should needs to be. But here we go. Doesn't really show.
Yeah, it just shows his response, it looks like.
Yeah. Working at this time.
Yeah. Too far. Oh, we're on page 5 now. All right. Well, let's scroll down.
This is okay.
Wait, what? I thought these are even getting out of order. It looks like the post numbers.
Yeah.
Wow.
The most confusing AMA ever.
Yeah. I don't understand why he didn't do it through something else. I mean, I don't know.
Maybe they just want to try and get their current Razer people to see it.
Yeah, it doesn't really show. This is a minute ago in the forums, but
It looks like some of the Razer staff people are liking questions too.
How come?
Did they change something? I'm not even seeing his answers anymore.
Yeah. He's done. He went home.
Wow. Well, I got what? I don't know any of mine answered, but maybe one or two.
Yeah, I'm looking at his profile. Yeah, all his posts just disappeared.
Well, that's disheartening to say the least.
Wow.
He just ninja smoke bombed us.
Yeah, how you get?
Right.
This one's a minute ago. I like how you're already quoting specific discounts. That's much said. We'll have the details for discounts, etc. when Cortex is what? Okay.
Let's go back to the Razer Insider thing and see if he might have moved the answers, I guess. I don't know.
What is it?
It's not even like we could cut to a commercial.
Right?
No, I don't know what happened.
Yeah, he's gone. What the?
Wow, that's interesting. They actually have a chat on the Razer Insider page. I wonder why they didn't use that.
He's still answering questions. You just can't see him.
Did I get logged? Are we logged? No, I'm still logged in. I thought maybe we got logged out for a second there.
Wait. What's going on right now? Maybe they changed the link? No? Because I'm on his profile page and it shows that it has an AMA session on the OUYA and Razer Forge TV ongoing right now. Yeah, I don't even know. Here's another. Yes, it will. However, we're scaling back on the roll out globally until we get Cortex TV ready. But I don't know what the question was.
That sounded think the question might be if it would be available outside the U.S. Sounds like an answer to that.
And then here's, it will be coming Q4 2015. We're working on it and should have some news shortly. This depends on the architect of the Android TV. Yeah, we can't see any of his answers.
Yeah.
Okay. Well. Here's a. Will we be able to trade up our OUYA for a 4K TV at a $50 discount? Now, I thought about that. What if people like traded in their OUYA to get a 4K TV?
Guess it would depend on how much you have to put out to get that forge, you know?
Yeah.
But why trade if you're already getting a discount?
Yeah.
Whatever that number is.
Actually, you know, that'd be one way to mitigate cost to make sure that people are actually trading up from an OUYA, you know?
Right.
Well, I'm assuming they're going to go by usernames or something like that. But the only problem there is the ones who bought it just for media.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess they would have signed in at some time, right?
You have to sign in. There's no, like, they before you can bypass it, but I think they went in recent, and like as newer updates of the firmware, you had to log in order to even.
Hmm. Well, that is a bummer that there are no more replies there. I mean.
Wow.
Yeah, it looks like everyone's seeing the same thing.
Yeah. And while they do have a chat room on their site, it seems pretty dead. Nobody's said anything.
Well, they're four. Well, even though they're the new owners and all, their forum has been pretty dead. Ever since the news, I've been checking, and I haven't seen much activity at all. Even less than a specific other forum that I won't name. Luckily, things have gotten better since then.
I just posted on his wall and said we can't see replies on the AMA.
I wonder if I can even find his profile, because I did have it open, but I closed it. Yeah, okay, I can find his profile.
Last answer was 4 minutes ago.
Profile page.
Okay, this is just strange.
Yeah.
Hope he didn't just do a cut and run on us.
He bounced. It's like, well, I answered all the questions, all the other ones are duplicates.
Can't really argue that.
Did he outright answer anything about Netflix or Amazon? I didn't see anything like that. Does the Forge have those?
That's the one thing he didn't answer.
Mm-hmm. I don't think it does.
Because I didn't see that one. I know he didn't address mine as far as our alternative launchers going to be valid applications on the Forge.
Oh.
And he didn't answer the one I was asking on mine as far as will you be able to, you know, get your game Cortex ready or Forge ready and be testing on an OUYA? You know, that would be great to know. Because if I can make applications on the OUYA and have them work on the Forge, then that would be nice to know.
Well, there shouldn't be any issue because, again...
Unless they change the SDK.
I said, the ODK is not being changed anytime soon. Later, it may be different, but right now, everything is the same. But the Netflix, yeah, that's the one that's going to need to be answered. Everyone's still waiting on it. Okay, why do I feel like I should be asking you guys what you're doing this weekend because what's going on?
Yeah, I mean, that was definitely an odd ending to a
question. Oh, wait, oh, here we go. Hold on, I see him back. Let's see. Okay, yes. Okay, now we answered that one. They're back.
Ooh.
Answered that one.
His answers? Oh, okay. So they are back. Okay. Great.
So, let's see.
Hey, Jamal. Hey, my question got, my set of questions looks like it's got bumped to the first page. No.
Yeah, you know, that's a good question. Someone's asking, okay, regarding the discount that you mentioned for OUYA owners for the Forge TV bundle and standalone, how will it work if you have more than one OUYA? Will I receive discounts for multiple devices?
I would imagine so. I mean, if I have three kids, you know, and they all have OUYAs and I want to buy them all Forges, I should be able to get a discount on all three.
Right.
Okay, he just answered.
Okay, look, yeah, here we go. When will the Cortex launch on Forge TV? It's been a while, and Netflix will it be announced for the Forge or not? Cortex TV is slated for Q4 of 2015 for the Forge TV, Cortex TV, and we're working on Netflix at this time and should have an update shortly. Okay, so that's what he was talking about. Netflix, yeah. When will the Netflix standard
just update shortly?
We're working on this at the time and should have an update shortly. So that's good.
They got one a little further down. What will be the fee for games published to Google Play via the OUYA publishing brand? Do get in touch with the OUYA publishing team. We are still working out the processes at this time, but we should have some news shortly.
All right. He said, can you comment on the submission process to get games listed for sale on Forge TV? Will it be similar to the process OUYA has had? And will there be a higher requirement for polished products? Thank you for doing this AMA. We'll have more detailed submission information and process when we're ready to announce them. But the goal is to get polished games on the Cortex TV store so that our users will have a great experience with the games. All right. And then, yeah, that one, will the Forge be openly available to people outside the U.S.? He said, yes, it will. However, we're scaling back on the rollout globally until we get Cortex TV ready. And then do you push a global once it's rolled out? I
heard some bad reviews of it on Forge TV since it doesn't have Netflix and other stuff. So I guess they're trying to get this Cortex TV ready and then they're going to publish or push their global distribution out.
Most of those reviews are most likely, oh, no Netflix, 1 star.
Yeah.
Never underestimate the pull that Netflix has, man.
I mean, it's supposed to be a gaming device, but a lot of people use it for media devices also. So,
yeah,
got to be the best of both worlds.
Yeah, my mother-in-law has her son has an Xbox 360, and she uses it for Skype and everything else.
Yes, it's like a computer.
Yeah, it is. So, I mean, it's one of those things. You know, people come to expect it now on these consoles. So, if you don't bring it, you know, they'll go somewhere else.
All right. Kind of unrelated to OUYA, but now that we have a chance to talk to the CEO, I think it's a good time to ask a few questions. Cortex Stream, when will this arrive for the Forge TV? It's like Limelight or the NVIDIA grid service where you can stream games from your PC. And he says it's coming in the quarter four of 2015. Netflix, this is obvious. We're working on it and should be have some news shortly. Depending on the architecture of Android TV, and we're definitely given the feedback on this at this time.
Will the ODK change to allow devs to take out any DRM they have installed or provide local receipts? I actually don't know. If you're a dev, do get in touch with the OUYA team, and once they settle in, they'll provide you with the right info.
Oh yeah, he answered the question. He said that's a good question about the multiple OUYA devices, because we haven't thought about it, so thanks. When the Cortex TV is integrated with Forge TV, we'll be announcing the upgrade plan, and we'll definitely take into account your feedback about multiple devices when we do. All right.
Maybe I've forgotten, but did he say if Cortex would be something like we have envisioned OUYA Everywhere to be, or is it going to be more of a tight-fisted thing that they control what it goes on?
I believe there's like when they asked the question about being on the Shield TV.
Mm-hmm.
And he says that they would like to be on multiple platforms.
Okay.
I have a feeling that it might be like we thought OUYA Everywhere would be. They would control where it's going so that they can maintain the quality level.
Right.
Because they don't seem like they're just going to let anybody into the Cortex store.
Yeah. So, like, Duck Game's not going to make it in. I'm just joking.
I was just curious because, you know, if Cortex came around, you know, and they had a side loadable package for the store, I'd definitely be up for trying to throw it on Cyanogen, you know, maybe even keep the OUYA running a little bit longer here.
Mm-hmm.
You know, beyond the couple to 12 months or so.
So, they were able to get, like, the Android TV from the Nexus player onto the OUYA. There's probably, maybe somebody could do it, take the Forge and put it on, the Forge TV and put it on the OUYA. I don't know.
Be interesting.
You know someone's going to try it.
Yeah. If I knew how to do it, I would try it, but I don't know how to do it.
Oh, wait a minute. He answered the question about the 15 people. I don't know why someone asked, but basically the store team, the QA, and the publishing team were kept from OUYA. And the store team, I assume he means the tech.
Okay, well, OUYA received a firmware update. I assume you mean the OUYA device, as we only acquired some of the assets and not the hardware business. We won't be supporting the OUYA device. I have no idea if there will be a firmware update for the device by another party, though.
So, it sounded more and more like Forge has no intention to release an update for the OUYA device itself, which, I mean, understandable. They didn't buy it, so...
Mm-hmm. But since, I guess...
Well, there is going to be one, or supposed to be one.
I guess, who's it coming from, then? I mean, is OUYA hardware still an entity of its own?
Well, they do have the tech people still there. I'm assuming they just want to keep the thing going until, you know...
They switch everybody over. Yeah, so they switch everybody over to the Forge. So it's either get a Forge or be out of gas.
That's what it sounds like.
I don't know about that. You may end up having someone, you know, some mysterious person keeping the lights on.
Would be interesting. Would be interesting.
Yeah, as long as Killswitch doesn't kill the Switch, then we'll be all right.
I do have to wonder. I mean, they said they're going to keep the QA team. Is that the game QA team? Because,
Yeah.
I'm still a little upset about Hero Generations, man. That thing never quite worked right.
Oh, right.
Well, I know, I know Kelly made it, and Tim, and probably Jared, so, like, all of them made it.
They're there, Bob's there, Mike is there.
Carl.
I don't know about Carl, but, I guess Carl counts as a QA team.
Yeah. So, I guess, so OUYA is going to be, like, just a branch of the Razer, just their publishing branch, I guess.
That's what it, yeah.
So when his, don't tell me his, all his answers disappeared again.
I'm seeing a couple here. This one's a repeat. When will the Forge TV be available to other regions like Europe? Given the acquisition, we're holding back on global rollout until we integrate Cortex TV store into the Forge TV quarter four. Once that's done, we'll continue with the global rollout. And then there's any plans on making / hiring a studio to make exclusive games for Forge TV? Nope. Firstly, we don't make games, nor do we ever have any plans to. And we don't like exclusive gamers. Or we don't like exclusives as gamers.
I like that answer.
I like that. Yeah, it's like
makes sense.
And when you think about it, it's just like free-to-games. You're giving somebody $100,000 or whatever it is, and the game may never show up.
Yeah.
So it looks like we have 3 minutes left. All right, 2 minutes now.
And, yeah, I think his questions disappeared again. Because I'm not seeing them again. I just read those two refreshed and they're gone.
Unless they got bumped up to the front. I don't know. I'm thinking.
Well, let's try that.
Yeah, I got nothing.
Clicky.
Yeah, there we go.
Yes. Okay, yeah, I see some of them.
So, they're all getting pushed to the front, I'm guessing. I saw a Taco Punk. Had a question. Let's see. What is the official stance on modding the Forge TV with external hard drive work as storage for games? Does it have HDCP? We don't know.
Well, that was another thing that I'm surprised they didn't ask. Was it a CEC or something, being able to, you know, control your TV and everything else with the other controllers. That was one thing that OUYA said they were going to do. I wonder if Forge has any idea on that.
I really think that OUYA will be a great addition to Razer's arsenal, but the important question I have is, will it be Razer toaster compatible? And when is the Razer Toaster plan to have design / product started? This is obviously something we've been waiting for years now. Any light you could shed would be greatly appreciated. And then you again, security.
Wow.
Razer toaster. Is this the same Razer that made the Razer phone?
No, that was Motorola, I think.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, I guess that's all, folks.
Yeah. Well, was interesting. At least got a few questions, you know. I guess the rest of them will get answered a little bit later, maybe.
Not what I was expecting, but okay.
Yeah.
Are we sure he signed off, though?
Not yet.
Since things keep moving around.
Yeah.
Looks like there's another one here. I was a prominent backer of OUYA because I believe the world needs a mainstream game console that is an open platform. The days of walled gardens dominating... I'm sorry, gardens? Yeah, walled gardens dominating the living room must come to an end. Will Razer continue that mission? Will Forge TV be at least as open a platform as PCs are? And his reply is, that's our vision, and I hope we will not disappoint you.
We have, when will the Forge TV be available to other regions like Europe? Given the acquisition, we're holding back global rollout until we integrate the Cortex TV store into the Forge TV in quarter four. And once that's done, we'll continue with the global rollout, which he already answered.
Yeah.
Let me see. I'm going to reply to some of these questions. No.
Stop it.
Let's see. How's my reply look? What happened to my... They must like have him only reply.
No, I see yours. It says no.
Okay. I posted it. Now I can't even see it.
I should reply to yours. Pretty please.
what happened to the current hardware? Answer that. Side loading is answered. Okay, will OUYA's social media account be maintained throughout acquisition, or will they eventually be absorbed into Razer's media, social media accounts? The new OUYA will transition to be a publishing arm of OUYA, or of four Android TV / Android-based TV console games, and they will need their voice too. So in short, they will have their own independent social media channel. All right.
So that means OUYA has to talk.
Do you plan to update them?
best of luck with that.
Doesn't say he's gone, but don't see him.
Let's see. Scrolling through the comments.
And it's very weird that they keep bumping those to the front. It's really very weird. Makes it very hard to keep track of what's being said.
Seeing anything else.
I guess maybe we can go and answer some of the unanswered questions. So, someone asked, does the Forge TV run with Elite Xbox One or with the Xbox One Elite or other Bluetooth controllers or just Razer? Well, the OUYA controller is compatible with the Forge TV. So, there's that one.
Oh, how about this one? Will existing OUYA owners be able to use their current controllers?
controllers are going to turn off in 12 months.
just put a link to one of the other posts where you actually answered the question. Please see post number.
contact the OUYA publishing team.
Here, contact Tim. Let me give you his name, his number. Here you go.
The Forge TV only has 16 gigs storage. Will I be able to store or run games on external hard drive? He already answered that question.
With them having OUYA's tech team, I would assume it wouldn't be long before that's done.
Yeah.
Let's see. How will the new Razer hardware fare against the old OUYA hardware? Really?
A lot better.
Some of these questions are painful.
I think some people are just trolling.
I don't know if that's true.
Or they could be legitimate.
Yeah, because some people, for whatever reason, never heard of the Forge.
I got to say, I had heard of it, but I was unaware that it was even released personally.
Yeah. I don't think that many people know about it either.
Yeah. I think I asked you the other day, Kill Switch, I was like, is this thing actually out or no or what? Is it coming? I don't understand.
Yeah, that might be because the shield was launched right over it and everyone forgot it was there.
Yeah.
Because without the shield, I think it is actually the most powerful console out of the rest of them.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely over the Nexus player.
Yeah. Yeah. Though, I mean, in all fairness, what is the Nexus now in the States? Like $79? $80?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
A little bit of a price gap there. Speaking of price gaps, that's definitely going to be one thing, because I know I was looking, and what is the shield? Like 200, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, the stock price of the Forge is, what, 150, unless you have that other coupon or some other discount. So, I mean, that's $50. I mean, I wonder how many people will be willing to pay that 50 just for the NVIDIA name.
A lot. But you can also just buy the unit for 100 because the controller works.
Oh, okay. Well, that's even more interesting.
But
so Mr. Tin is gone, and in the meantime, they will try to get more questions answered.
What else could they really answer here? They're almost all the same.
Yeah. Streaming service like Hulu, Netflix, Xfinity TV be supported on the OUYA/Forge TV.
Coming soon.
Need to get a picture of that, what is it, the Velociraptor tapping his chin. Maybe.
What will be the fee for games published to Google via OUYA? You know OUYA publishing is free, so why ask? Well, you got to get these questions. Got to get harder questions.
Timmy is calling out Riot on the... I'm not going to repeat what he says, but yeah.
Last page. Quick.
Wow. Well, I guess that's a wrap.
Yeah.
Stay tuned to the OUYA forums, and maybe we can get some more unanswered questions answered, especially about this DRM. Well, I mean, it does depend on the developers to do it, but
I mean, I wouldn't even ask the question at this point. It is the developers.
So we got to ask the developers.
Yeah, that's when everything gets moved over to Cortex, it'll be based on the developers updating their game, just like OUYA everywhere. Same situation.
Right.
Well, as far as on the Forge, not on the OUYA devices, because the OUYA devices are kind of contingent on being able to make that check. And if they shut it down, you know, the only, I guess the only recourse the developer would have would be to make it DRM free. But then, you know, you run the risk of, or use some alternative DRM, but then you run the risk of somebody just taking your APK and installing it on anything.
Right. Or what if, okay, say if a developer gets their game converted over to the Cortex TV store, and mm-hmm. then you just, they give you, you know, a code that way you can unlock it on for the Forge for games that you already purchased.
I would have, I mean, I would be of the mindset that when they convert these things over to the Cortex store, if you buy a Forge or if you get a Forge or whatever the case may be, and you already had an OUYA, it sounded to me like he's trying to make their accounts convert over, so you should keep the same licensing, I would imagine.
Right.
I mean, I think what majority of the people are really worried about is if they decide to, you know, not get a Forge right away and kind of kick around their OUYA still, you know, what's going to happen.
Right.
And that, again, that'll go back to the developer on if they remove the DRM or not.
Yeah. You know, one thing I would like to see, and I emailed, I haven't heard anything back yet. Is there a way for developers to find out more information on whom purchased their application? Because in this case, you know, like my applications, I was considering running my DRM and stuff myself, but I need to have some way to know who to contact to get an email address or something to have some sort of verification built into the application. But as of right now, developers don't have any way to identify who owns their application in order to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And then on top of that, you know, should the lights go out, you know, whatever date that may be, if somebody contacts you, you know, how, as a developer, how do you verify that that person did indeed buy your application?
Yeah, I'll show you a OUYA receipt.
Well, yeah, I mean, but then that'd be kind of easy to doctor, no? I mean, it's just an email.
Yeah. That's true.
So I've emailed that because I was thinking about that last week because I want to keep my applications running on the OUYA, you know, regardless whatever happens. And going forward, I don't want to have this same issue. But it's very interesting. It's an interesting situation because, you know, for the DRM, what do you do? You remove it, you highly increase the likelihood of your application being pirated. But if you don't, you know, you kind of hose the end users on the OUYA eventually.
Or no, like, sorry, say if a developer has a game on OUYA, and what if they pull it from the store, and then you don't have access to it any longer, and you purchase the game?
I think Killswitch seen that before, don't you? Doesn't it still show up on the store?
Someone said it did.
Like for Crystal me, Picnic did. Or somebody said it did. I've never had the privilege of having that happen to me. So I'm not sure.
That was the game. For me, it didn't show up, but for other people, it did. I don't know. Because, as you know, you see on Twitter, some people are saying they're pulling their games.
Yeah.
No.
It really makes no sense, but that's their
thing. None at all, no.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm... I know Amazing Frog was said that they might do that. So, you know, I purchased the game, and, you know, if they pull it, then I'm stuck without the game, and I purchased it, you know?
Yeah, I mean, the whole electronics distribution is inherently kind of like that, but, I mean, there's a whole lot of weird stuff going on with this particular instance.
I mean, if they want to give me, the Steam version exchange for the OUYA version, I'll take it.
But then you come back to the whole thing, how do they verify that you bought it?
Right.
There's no mechanism, so at least that I'm aware of. I haven't heard back in my email. I'm just speculating at this point. I haven't heard anything back. But, I mean, if there's no way for us to really verify that as a developer, you know, I'm not seeing an easy way for a developer not to get, you know, run over the barrel at the same time trying to help the customers.
Yeah, but right now, the situation with pulling games just because OUYA was bought by someone else...
No, that makes no sense at all. No.
But then again, half of them are saying OUYA died, which it didn't. OUYA Inc. isn't there anymore.
Yeah. I mean, companies get bought and sold every day of the week. There's nothing groundbreaking about it.
Yeah. I mean, did YouTube fail? I mean, they're still around. Google bought them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I'm really hoping, you know, the Forge purchase, the whole that whole Razer purchase, you know, puts OUYA on the right path. And I mean, it sounds like he's got that in mind, you know. My only thing is I hope he's a little bit loose on what he lets the Forge get put on, the Cortex TV put on. I mean, I would love to be able to load it on other devices and stuff, you know, kind of like we hoped OUYA Everywhere would be. But, you know, other than that, it sounds like he's got a good plan for it. I mean, making it a publishing thing is what everyone said OUYA should have been doing to begin with, that, you know, they probably should get out of the hardware business, you know, so.
Yeah, but I think what everyone saw was, you know, the sequel and then maybe that move. Because they weren't strong enough yet.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't see them putting out an OUYA 2 just because of the fact that, you know, when it comes to developing the games, a lot of the games that were out for the OUYA, I hate to say it, you know, they weren't really pushing the processor. They weren't really pushing the boundaries. And for there to be an OUYA 2, there needed to be a demand. People had a huge demand for the processing power, but nothing to use it on, you know?
But that's a catch-22 because other developers I spoke to wouldn't try to degrade their game to get it to run on it. So,
yeah, definitely. Yeah, and I mean that's why I said I just seen Arctic Dog and I we were talking about that not too well, I mean, I guess at this point it's been a while, but not too long after that whole OUYA 2 discussion started to really break out, you know. Whether they were going to go hardware or not, and that's what we just kept saying. You know, I don't see them going hardware anymore. They just
they'd be
far better off just going with the store and trying to get that onto as many devices as possible. Make that as open as possible because you know you don't need to make hardware to expand your audience if you have an open platform. And I'm using the word open. Open by meaning of you can put it on whatever device you want. You know, it may not work on every device. Clearly, I can't throw it on my TI-82. I understand this. But if you can put it on any reasonable device, I mean, you just instantly expanded your market. You know, I mean, I think that really is the best way to go if they're looking to, and even with Razer, if they're looking to increase their market, you know, is to kind of go that route, you know. Granted, it's not going to work on everything. Not everything works on everything, but
that goes right back to the same problem. Not enough strong games to get people to move over.
Well, if you have that type of a setup, though, you don't necessarily have to, you know, make people move over. People are going to be interested, and they're going to want to install the store just to see what's there, or maybe even just to install one game that they might be able to get cheaper on the Cortex store than they can on Google Play or whatever the case may be, and that might be their foothold. Mm-hmm. And once they're in the door and able to install it, especially if they're not charging anything for the store software itself, they let people install the software like the Amazon Market does. You know, if they go that route, you know, they could end up expanding themselves very, very quickly with minimal hardware investment.
Okay, but can you, let's say you look at the store as it is right now, would you say there's maybe 20 to 30 games that would get you to actually make the purchase right away?
On the OUYA store, are there games on there that I would purchase right away? If I had...
Hello?
Yeah.
I don't know what just happened.
Yeah, what happened here?
I know, he just cut out completely. I don't know what happened. All right, we're back, though.
Oh, okay.
What were you saying?
No, I was saying that, I mean, I don't know if I would buy anything right off the bat. I'm a terrible person for that question. I mean, when I got the OUYA, I didn't hesitate to buy anything off of that. But, I mean, I've bought things off of Google Play, and I play them on the OUYA. And so, I mean, I don't know what that counts for. I mean, I wouldn't have any reservation buying anything. I've bought, well, let me put it this way. I've actually bought things off the Amazon Marketplace, and I play them on the OUYA. And I bought it on the OUYA. I was browsing the Amazon Marketplace and bought it.
Well,
I guess that would be tomato, right?
Well, the way I'm looking at it, you have 1,100, whatever the number of games is. But you also have Google, you have Amazon, you have all the others. Now, if you open those stores, you'll see, you know, you look at the front page, you'll see 30, 40 games, whatever it is, and there's a good chance that you'll like a good percentage of those games.
Gotcha.
And right now, if you look at OUYA and put like 40 to 50 games there, it's questionable. You may get lucky and get every single good game, but then you have the ones that are broken.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think the one thing that Razer does and OUYA had going for it was, well, let me rephrase that. In theory, the one thing they had going for them was that they all worked very well with a controller. You know, they were all couch capable. Whereas Google Play, you know, that's hit or miss, more miss than hit. The OUYA store, you know, it kind of fell off there for a little while because of the QA. You know, it wasn't the best. Things were getting through that had no business getting through. Hero Generations. Fighting at you.
Fright Night.
Yes. I mean, there are some games that just had no business at all getting approved. I have no idea what happened. But, I mean, if you're using a device and your end game is to play it with a controller, then obviously you're going to want to purchase things from a store that's going to tell you, hey, this works with a controller. This is controller capable. You know what I mean? Right off the bat, you know that's going to happen. You don't have to, like, browse Google Play, for example, and try to read the details. Hey, did anybody happen to say, did this work with the MOGA controller? Does this work with what? I mean, you know, it's really hell trying to find things on Google.